Okay, this is a word out to everyone that's watching, to you, to your families, your friends, community, and world in general. And I would say we're going to assess, let us assess what our strengths are, because we are likely going into a very drastic situation in this world. And most people are feeling it. Everyone, I've sort of been doing a canvassing of so many different people from different walks of life, and everyone seems to have this feeling like, wow, you know, the future seems very iffy and intense. No one quite really has a handle on it at all, actually. And it's been getting more and more and more in that way. So I think we have to be very serious about it and assess what our strengths are. And so what I can do, if I were to tell someone, you know, what my strengths were, each one's assessing, okay, what kind of strengths do we have to help us go forward here in some way, or at least maintain our peace of mind and equilibrium and not come apart. I would say, well, I would start out by saying, well, I had a very fortunate to have a great opportunity presented to me when I was young, still, like, let's say, 22 years old. I had a great opportunity presented to me, and I jumped at it and took the opportunity. And it basically was a non-dual belief system. The non-dual belief system was made available to me, and I realized this was an opportunity, big opportunity, huge opportunity. And so I took the opportunity. I said, yes, this is what I'm going to do with my life. And so I committed to it, absolutely committed to it. And what I can say is, it's extremely difficult to gauge your progress on the non-dual, in non-duality. I can't say, have I been successful, non-successful? I can't really judge my progress. I can't really measure it. But one thing that I can measure is perseverance. And I would say, when it comes to perseverance, I would give myself an A+. I can say that for almost 40 years, every single day of those 40 years, I have given it everything I've got and have persevered every single day with great intensity and effort and focus and determination and commitment to it. So what kind of payoff does this perseverance provide? I don't know. There's another I don't know. But I certainly have been told, and I've been aware that there are those who say the whole key to success on the non-dual path, to get the payoff, so to speak, the benefit of it, is great perseverance. That's actually what it takes. And so if you look at it that way, then, you know, you could say, well, there's reason to be somewhat optimistic that I will be, have something to bring to the table, both in a family, friends, community, and world, you know, something to bring to the table. So I would say it's like 50-50 right now. There's three different possibilities, I would say. One is that nothing comes of it, and I'm just, you know, dud. It's a dud. Two is that something comes of it, but it's kind of, eh, so-so. And then the third is that there's a big payoff. Really big payoff. Those are the three possibilities. So, you know, I'm just saying, well, it's, you know, it's kind of 50-50-ish. You know, I feel, you know, it's, you could say, well, it might just be a dud, or you'd also say that there's going to be a payoff, and I'm not really sure how big of a payoff, but it's 50-50. I'm not pessimistic, and I'm not overly optimistic. I'm just continuing to persevere. But I would say that there's not many like this in the world, someone who's persevered this long with this sort of curriculum, very, very advanced curriculum. It's not very common. I mean, it's tough to persevere, very difficult. And, you know, people don't get results quickly. They tend to want, you know, drop out and say, well, it's too difficult. I'm not getting the results. Well, I still don't have the results after 40 years. So, I mean, just the very fact of being able to persevere like this, that there's a lot to say about that, actually. Uh, not being able to judge, really determine, you know, concretely, you know, where's the progress, where's the payoff? I don't have it yet. I don't have the payoff. I still feel I'm in, you know, just like totally, you know, floundering, just floundering. Not totally floundering, but still no payoff. So it's a very interesting situation. And this is just an honest assessment. I hope there's a payoff, but my experience it has been that no matter how much I hope that there's going to be a payoff soon, so far it hasn't happened. I have to, you know, have to be clear about that. It has not happened yet. Despite indications that a payoff is coming, despite those indications. Now, I do believe there will be a payoff, but I don't know when, and I don't know how strong it will be. But I do feel that there's this, you can say it's a potential asset that could be quite significant and quite helpful. So it's a potential asset. It's not something that should be just written off. It's something that gives at least people some hope that, you know, the cavalry may be arriving at some point. If the payoff's big, then I would say, you know, it would be very helpful. For a lot of people, for the world in general. If it's just a small payoff, I think it would still be helpful, but maybe on a lesser scale. And if it's a dud, then it's a dud. And that's the way it is. I don't believe it's going to be a dud, but I don't know. Timing-wise, I just can't, I cannot, it's just, this, assessing it is just, it just doesn't work. It has never worked. How can you assess, you know, giving up trying to succeed, giving up, you know, setting down the effort to do anything? I mean, how can you assess how close you are? Because any effort to assess it, it gets in the way of it. You know, it's a very delicate, tricky thing, the non-dual position. You know, it's like any effort you make to set down effort, that just nullifies, you know, it just gets in your way and you're spinning your wheels. So you try not to measure anything. It's giving up measurement, really. It's giving up assessment. That's what it's all about. Stop assessing what you are, because that's what's preventing you from knowing what you are, from experiencing what you are. The attempt to assess it, to measure it, to define it, that's what gets in the way. So, you know, that's why I cannot say, well, where am I at? I can't say, because when I try to say it, it seems like I'm going backwards. Just getting away from it. So, but still, I will have to reiterate that the great teachers, the ones that have the payoff has come for them, they do stress very strongly that great perseverance is what it takes, and only those who persevere to the end, you know, really will get the payoff. And so, you know, I have to be in that category of great perseverance. There's no question about that. That's something, and this is something, you know, that's not just some intellectual grasping. 40 years of intense perseverance cannot just be, you know, a concept. It's not a concept. You know, I've done it. It's water under the bridge. I've already done it. The familiarity is already there. And so that's something that cannot be just dismissed lightly. There's no way that can just be turned into a concept and then brushed aside. You know, that's, you know, folly to do that. Perseverance in the right direction is an extraordinarily important attribute. So I still have some confidence. Let's switch to now a dream that I had last night, and along these lines of, you know, where are we at? Is there any help coming? Because the intensity of the world is things seem to be that they're headed towards some sort of drasticness in various ways. Some say it's already there. Technocratic takeover of this planet, I would say, is an extraordinarily drastic situation for those who don't want it. You know, for those who want it, they think, oh, you know, this is great. For those who don't want that, it is like a disaster, an extreme disaster, actually. And so I put myself in that camp. I believe that a technocratic culture, society, civilization, we're not being well served by that at all. Not at all. It's the opposite of non-dual duality. It's extremely dualistic. It's extraordinarily dualistic. So it is very much at odds with the payoff that we're looking for in the non-dual perspective. So I had this dream last night, and there was this massive concrete platform, foundation, massive, and thick. It must have been like 20 feet thick, let's say. Deep, 20 feet deep. I mean, it was just a solid mass of concrete, and there were people walking upon it. I was walking upon it, and we were kind of looking like, wow, look at how you know, impenetrable this foundation is. You know, this is the feeling like, wow, we really done something really great in terms of pouring concrete. Now, so I was looking at it, and then I noticed something. I noticed a little something in the concrete. It was a very smooth slab. It seemed, you know, just absolutely solid. And I noticed, a little hole. And I said, what the world is that? You know, and I went over and kind of looked at it. I said, what is that? Then I noticed another hole suddenly popped up. And then another. And I began looking. I said, well, something weird is happening here. And I looked at the holes. It was like something had been boring from underneath, boring up through the concrete slab all the way to the surface. And there was a smooth, you know, round hole going down into the slab of concrete. Something had come up, somehow it bored up to the surface. And I don't know if it was coming from the bottom of the slab or where it was coming from. And I could not determine what was doing the boring. And so this became a great interest to me, and I tried to point out to others, and I said, hey, folks, you know, most people, we weren't paying attention. And then the holes began getting bigger. You know, they started out just a pinhole, and then like a pencil hole, and then, they got larger, half inch, 2 inches. And I was quite astonished by this, and I could not determine what was doing this, how this was happening, what was causing this. And it was an extraordinary phenomena. How this was like hardened concrete, and something was boring right through it. But what it was, I could not determine. Okay, so this continued on, and I was really wrapped up in examining this and observing it. And then suddenly, I found the entire center of this massive slab of concrete suddenly got bored through and disappeared, and I found myself standing on ground, like grassy ground, and the whole center of this huge slab was gone. I was just like, what? I mean, it was like, you know, how many, 100 feet wide borehole had suddenly bored through the concrete, and it was just all gone. There was only just peripheral parts of the slab left, really. And so I was just shocked in a tremendous wow experience. Okay, now fast forward to today. I'm taking a nap. Actually, this morning I woke up, same thing happened, but I'm taking a nap today. And I doze off, and then I wake up, and my mind is like in a sort of normal state of mind where it's thinking this, that, all sorts of thoughts going around. And then suddenly, just like, whew, like that, my mind suddenly became completely quiet. All the thoughts just vanished, completely quiet, whew, just experiencing that. And then gradually the thoughts started filtering back in, and when I went back to sleep, I woke up again, the same thing happened. And this happened a number of times, that my mind just went still and quiet, without me, just spontaneously. I didn't make any effort to accomplish this at all. It just went quiet. Now I'm wondering, is this have something to do with those boreholes in this concrete slab? That they're just appearing. I couldn't tell what was causing them, but, you know, something, some spaciousness suddenly appeared in that concrete slab. A concrete slab might be something that represented, you know, lack of spaciousness, lack of awareness of spaciousness. And then suddenly a little borehole appeared that you look in and you say, oh my God, it's spaciousness, you know, appeared. And more and more and more and bigger and bigger and bigger. And then suddenly, again, there's the whole center, the entire center of that slab just disappeared. There's just nothing but spaciousness there. And I don't know, you know, how it happened. I didn't make any effort to do it. I wasn't aware of any mental effort. So as I'm waking up from this nap, dozing on and off, my mind suddenly just, all my thoughts just vanish. My whole mind just quiets down on its own. So I wonder if there's some connection, you know, between this dream and then what's happening right now. And, you know, if there is there some, you know, suddenly a huge spaciousness suddenly just is there, you know? Well, maybe, yeah, I don't know. I'm just looking at it. You're not counting our chickens before they're hatched. But it's possible, isn't it? It's possible. It's possible. You know, let's say 50-50. Yeah, let's just say 50-50. Is it possible that all this effort, you know, is going to pay off? Well, I don't know. But I certainly was experiencing my mind that was just full of ordinary, like, you know, dream thoughts. You wake up and you're thinking about this and you realize your mind's very active. And I was aware that the mind was active. And suddenly that awareness of that my mind was so active, all the thoughts just kind of collapsed and vanished, just sort of evaporated away very quickly. Like in about a second or less, actually. That quick, I just, poof, gone. They all just suddenly, like shadows, like when you shine a light, how shadows just kind of, you know, how quickly they vanish, right? It was sort of like that. Like turning a light on and the shadows just gone, that like that. And my mind was just not thinking anything. There was no thoughts at all, really. I was just aware of the quietness of the mind. Now, I don't know what to make of it. I've had so many experiences in the last 40 some odd years that, you know, I just have to just sit in the wow of it and don't try to measure it or assess it or do anything about it. I've had too many disappointments thinking that, you know, some payoff was finally arriving and it has not. So I just have to take this wow, just take it and full stop in the wow. Just continue with the discipline. That's all. I feel it's the best that anyone can do along the way towards, you know, hope for payoff of accepting, you know, the non-dual belief system, is that you just have to, when you experience something, just say, wow, don't try to measure it. Don't try to measure it at all. So when I was experiencing that in that dream where suddenly there was just nothing but spaciousness in the middle of this huge concrete slab that was like 20 feet thick, it just all vanished. There's no concrete slab there at all, just this round circle, this huge circle of spaciousness. There's nothing but spaciousness, empty space there, spaciousness. I just said wow in the dream. I just said wow. I didn't try to assess anything or measure anything or project anything, expect anything, you know, try to figure out how it happened or anything. I just was aware that this is the situation now. And just was trying to just full stop in the wow. So I have said over and over and over, I believe that this full stop in the wow is the most helpful practice that anyone can engage in. And we can all engage in it. Doesn't matter what our socioeconomic status is, really. Even a homeless person can do this. In fact, you know, well, they have their challenges, you know, a lot. So, but they can do it. Just as we can do it, just as wealthy people can do it, anyone can do this. I find my situation here helps out a lot. You know, I have a pretty balanced life, and I have, you know, opportunity to work at this every day. So I do that. Now, in this dream, were all those little boreholes that sort of popping up, and were those representative of previous experiences I've had of little breakthroughs, maybe, and the breakthroughs getting greater and greater and greater, maybe. But I certainly, it went from a little breakthrough to this, you know, huge borehole. Just all the concrete was gone, and in this borehole, so there was this sort of quantum leap that took place, actually. But I was not overwhelmed. I just said, wow, this is really a big wow. That's how I looked at it. Wow, this is really a huge wow. And okay, let's manage the wow, you know, full stop on the wow. Let's not try to figure anything out, not describe it, not try to express it, not try to define it, measure it, evaluate it. Just say, it is what it is. It just is what it is, that's all. This might be a saying of just full stop on the wow. It just is what it is. And leave it at that. Don't go do any further than that. This is I am now. You can say, this is I am now. This is I am now. Concrete slab could have symbolized our unawareness of pure spaciousness, the ground of being, our unawareness of the ground of being. We've tried to symbolize the obliteration of that through this massive concrete slab, and then this experience in the dream showed that the spaciousness, you know, the awareness that it's still there in very, very strong terms. Possible, but again, I just, you know, it is what it is. It seems to me that this technocratic society is a society that worships and idolizes this concrete slab. And this is why I feel it is so inappropriate for us. Very inappropriate. They take it as primary. Say, wow, look at what we've done. This is just awesome. This is reality. This is our foundation of being, you know, that we can count on this concrete, the concreteness, the lack of spaciousness, and it's solid, it's impermeable, and all this. So anyway, I just want to say that it is what it is. I had this dream, I experienced this, and I'm having these experiences now. My mind just spontaneously going quiet. And it just feels like just there's only spaciousness there, you might say. And I just said, wow, okay, it is what it is. I made a decision yesterday that I'm going to keep on persevering, and I stopped paying attention to the news. I realized I had to make this decision because I was getting so upset with the news. I felt like I needed to jump in and do something about it, you know, concretely, and I really was getting too feisty about it. So I realized I really have to decide which way to go, and I decided, okay, let's persevere with this path. It's difficult because we want some sort of concrete results, right, in the world. We see everything going in the wrong, bad trends, and we think, wow, I just want to make a difference. And on the path of non-dual consideration, it's tough to assess, you know, what can I do concretely at all? Anyone can, you know, is there anything? And you don't see it. So it's frustrating, very frustrating. But I realized that I would be fighting a quixotic, Quixotian battle, you know, to try and be a single person standing up to technocratic society, you know, picketing Google or something or Facebook, and nobody's going to join me. You know, it's just not going to happen. I mean, it doesn't work that way right now. They've got things pretty well sewn up in a lot of ways, and it's just, I said, you know, that. Why throw your life away like that? It's futile. that direction is futile. So let me continue on with my strength, which is this perseverance in what I've been doing. Full stop in the wow. Let's just continue. So I decided to stop listening to the news. I haven't seen the news either yesterday or today. And someone, okay. Wow, it's later than I thought. And so I made the decision. I'm going to continue on with this. So hopefully that's a good decision that, you know, some of us can applaud. It's an important decision. I'm going to continue on hoping that, you know, something, there is some payoff with this. Even though, again, that I don't have any way to really assess it. Just cannot. It's inscrutable. It's very inscrutable. It's like saying, how close are you to like doing nothing? How can you assess it? You know, how can you measure that? You cannot. That's why it just takes dogged perseverance. But that's something that I have done in the face of just not knowing, you know, what am I, you know, am I, is this going towards a payoff, or I don't know. Certainly there are signs that you seem to be making some sort of progress, but even that, you know, is somewhat nebulous. The ultimate payoff, it remains nebulous. It really does, and it's frustrating. You think, wow, I've been working so diligently at this, and yet I really don't know where I stand at all. And so, you know, you feel, it's easy to feel frustrated, and I just, and you just have to, even though you feel frustrated, you just have to continue. There certainly doesn't seem to be any other option in the world as far as, you know, effectiveness. I couldn't see anything except just want, you know, be just a ridiculous activist that nobody's going to really go to that, you know, be that strong, and you know, no one's going to have your back at all if you really are a very intense activist right now. In order to be pragmatically, in order to be ideologically affected, you'd have to be an extraordinary activist. So much so that other people say, I can't be that strong. There's no way. It's too much, too much. And so you just you'd be on your own, and it wouldn't be effective. It would not be effective. Whereas, if there is a payoff with this non-dual consideration, that could be actually very effective, very helpful for many. So I said, you know, you just weigh it, you know, weigh it, and you have to say this is the right decision. The other way is certain defeat. This way is 50-50. So you go with the 50-50, and rather than certain defeat. You know, even though it might be heroic defeat, you know, it would be a Pyrrhic sort of victory, you know. It's like a moral victory, but being absolutely crushed. That doesn't help anyone, actually. They just say, what an idiot, you know. What a fool. Yeah, try, you know, just, there's no chance of success, and try it anyway. That's not something to follow. So, zero chance of success, or 50-50, you know, take the 50-50. Now, this experience of the mind going quiet, I've never experienced this before, first time ever. And I cannot account for it. And indeed, I don't try. I just say, wow, and that's it. Don't try to account for it. Remember, full stop in the wow is the key discipline. This is my belief. I very strongly believe in this. Do not try to make any assessments at all. It just is what it is, and just get used to it. This is ultimately what it is remaining in abstraction. Try to remain in pure abstraction. Do not allow anything other than pure abstraction to jump into the scene. Push it away. Don't get dragged away from pure abstraction. It just is what it is. and I'm not going to make any other, you know, any assessments of it at all. That's it. Full stop. Yeah, you know, this is not, you know, it's easy, but to continue on and keep doing it, you know, it takes a lot of, you know, determination and will, and you really have to believe this is important, very important. So I'm trying to stick with good habits now, and simply give full attention to this. Not listen to the radio. Don't look at any news stories on the internet or newspaper or anything. And just, you know, give full attention to full stop in the wow. And I hope that by doing this, that there, you know, something will, this will be beneficial, and ultimately the 50-50 proposition, you know, tilts in direction of a payoff, because that's ultimately what I really want. The suffering of all of us disturbs me greatly. It just seems like, you know, we're better than that, and we really don't deserve all this death and misery and insecurity and fear and confusion. And I just don't see that as being what we are at all. It's like a dream state. I see everyone wandering around in a dream state is the way I see it. And I know that we're better than that. This does not represent what we are. These bodies, this world, this universe does not represent what we are at all. It's a misrepresentation of what we are. An extraordinarily extreme misrepresentation of what we are. And so I just, you know, this is how I see the situation. And I know that, you know, that there's a spirit, you know, an aspect of spirit believing that they're this body wandering around and with very dull mental confusion, being stupid this way and this and struggling. But I know it's just a dream, you know. They believe that it's real for them. Now it's not real at all, and yet just like a dream, we think the dream is so real. And spirit seems, you know, to be like, oh my gosh, you know, this is horrible, I've always had the compassion for this situation, a very strong compassion. I said, what can be done here? You know, how do we wake up from this dream? This is awful. It's an awful dream. And we're not doing a very good job of waking up from it. That is for sure. I don't see technocratic society, civilization as, you know, an optimal way of waking up from the dream at all. It tries to perfect the dream. It tries to, you know, it tries to make the dream more real, and then tries to escape the effects, the bad effects of the dream. And this is not the way, at least the non-dual explanations are, that this is the mistake that we make. This is crucial mistake is we try to make illusions real and then escape the effects of these illusions. This is what continues to entrap us in the dream. This is the very, you know, concrete that keeps us deluded. So certainly I'm alarmed at the direction the world has taken. Very alarmed by it. Have been alarmed my whole life. I realized this is the way things are trending. This is not good. And it seems paradoxical, right? To just sit here and do nothing, full stop in the wow, and just go into this quiet mind, this neutral, it just is what it is. And we think, no, we need to get free. We need to do something. No, the realization is there's delusions are not real. They don't have real effects. Therefore, accepting this as a fact, we are free of it. I mean, we have to accept that we're inherently free of all illusions. They don't touch us, bind us in any way. There's nothing we need to do to get free of them. So it's the realization of this which is important, not struggling with the effects of a dream, you know, an unreal dream. Struggling with the effects just solidifies the belief that the dream is real, actually. So it's not really paradoxical. It doesn't please both camps. And we think, well, we need to please the camp of, you know, getting rid of bad effects. No, we don't have to please that. And if we realize we don't have to please that, then it's no longer paradoxical. You see, once you realize the difference between duality, dualistic belief system, the non-dual belief system, and realize you can't please both of them, then it's not paradoxical anymore. The paradox vanishes because you realize, oh, I'm pleasing, you know, the non-dual belief, I'm going with that, and this fits perfectly. And I'm not pleasing the other. I cannot please both. When we try to please both, you feel yourself wrapped up in a paradox, in an enigma, in a mystery, everything, and just you feel like it's just, and then you think that there's a God that somehow can satisfy this paradox, and there isn't. That type of God doesn't exist. That's why the nihilists, the a lot of atheists get into this position of seeming, wow, it's just all paradoxical. Because they're trying to serve two masters. They say, I don't understand how it's possible. They think they have to. And then that leads to them think, well, either praying to a God to solve this paradox or to satisfy the paradox, or they go atheistic and say, you know, there can't be any God, you know, we're just stuck in this paradox. And, you know, that's where we're at. Nihilistic, you become nihilistic. You go into anarchy, actually what happens is you get into this mindset where you feel like you're stuck in this paradox and you feel it's just totally unfair and you just feel like you want to just destroy everything. So anarchy is a big problem in this world right now. There's a lot of people who have mindsets that are geared towards anarchy. A lot. More than we realize, actually. And we've seen that in various situations that have arisen recently where mobs just, the mentality of anarchy just takes over. And you might say, we don't know exactly how strong this mood is in the world, but I would say it's increasing every day to a very alarming extent. And this is a result of, you might say, that we have, it's not that religion's failed us, we've failed religion. I mean, the religion just means to be very dedicated in your consideration and contemplation of truth. And we haven't been dedicated enough. And we're not, when we're not dedicated enough, what happens is we think we have to serve two masters that are mutual exclusives, and then we feel that we're trapped in a paradox. And then that brings this feeling of, wow, this, I just can't take this, and it can easily, that will spill into anarchy, destructiveness, just lashing out, you know, in all directions. Let's just tear everything down. Let's just tear it all down. And then, of course, that gives a pretext to severe bureaucratic, technocratic control. Absolutely it does. It's almost like technocratic control is an outcome of this anarchy. So you first you have paradox, first you try to, lack of dedication, try to serve two masters, feel locked in a paradox, turns towards anarchy, which then actually desperately demands that there be some very strict technocratic control to prevent the anarchy. This is kind of the collapse of civilization is what happens. And we're right there right now. We are there right now. So it is a crisis. There's no question. It's a crisis. And I decided, you know, let's just keep on going with the 50-50. It's better than trying to jump in and sway the, you know, anarchists and all of this who don't have the right background to understand what the heck you're talking about at all. So I would say that element is not very reachable right now. But there's a large element that could be reachable who might say, wait a minute, maybe there isn't really a paradox. Maybe the non-dual is true. And if that's true, we don't have to please the dualistic belief system. Therefore, the paradox is gone. It's not there. It's like the rope and the snake. You know, when you're trying to serve two masters, you see it as a snake. When you decide, no, I'll go with the non-dual. Then suddenly it's a rope again. It's a rope. Paradox is gone. And you don't feel that you need to go towards anarchy, and nor then you need to go towards some severe draconian technocratic bureaucratic control, right? To just keep you under control because you're just you've been acting out. You don't want to keep acting out because you realize it's so self-destructive. You don't need to go in that direction. So there is hope for some in the world. Potentially. I don't know if that hope will manifest or not. I cannot assess that. I certainly want it to. I really want it to. And the discipline would be full stop and the wow. Because if it does manifest, that's a huge wow. Because you're pulling back from the brink. And that's a huge wow. So this is why it's so important to realize that when you're like ready to go step off a cliff and you realize I'm stepping off a cliff and that's it. I'm going into destruction. I'm going into anarchy. This is horrible. And then you stop and then you take a step back and say, wait a minute. I don't have to go off the cliff. You know, how big of a wow is that? It's tremendous. So you might take a step back and then just sit down and say, oh, wow. And gather your nerve, you know, and then kind of inch your way back, push your way back, and keep kind of sliding back from the edge of the cliff. This is kind of how it has to go. Slide your way back from the cliff and just remain quiet, remain silent, like that, full stop on the wow. So it's not like a dramatic, like you just simply turn around from the cliff and run the other way and say, ah, you know, it's too shocking because you realize, oh, I almost went the wrong way, but I didn't. And that's something incredibly profound for us. There's a great profundity to that has to be acknowledged and you just need to say, you know, sit down for a while and just say, wow. Just sit down and be quiet. Just let it sink in, you know. Don't blah 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 blah, blah, blah talk it away. Just acknowledge that this is real. That you made a great decision. How cool is that? You made a great, great decision that saved you enormous misery. So how important is that? Well, you know, there's not much that's any more important than that, really. I mean, you look at the standpoint of pragmatically, there's nothing really more important than that. It's fundamental. Because once begun is half done, you know, it's that important. So it's immeasurably important. Let's put it this way. It is immeasurably important, and therefore we must not try to measure it. So if something really big, helpful does happen, then you know what to do is sit in silence. Sit in silence. Don't try to measure it. Don't even try to express it. Oh, thank you so much. And you're trying to define it. You're trying to measure it. Yeah. Don't do that. If someone's really helpful in this world, then being really helpful means you've just pulled back from the brink, and that means this is just immeasurably profound for you. So don't try to express it, don't try to measure it. This will take you out of it. Just be silent, be quiet, be silent. Full stop in the wow. Okay, so this is a lot to consider. I'll let this percolate, and those who hear it will hear it. And maybe, some of it will sink in and just say, hey, okay, that's possible, and what do I need to do? Full stop in the wow? Silent? Be quiet? Be silent? Let me practice this right now. Do not define, do not measure, do not plan, do not assess, it just is what it is. However I see it without words, just let it be that. Don't try to attach words to it. This is a journey beyond words. Don't try to attach words to it. Or just say it is what it is, or wow. Very abstract term, just wow. So I would say, try to make a decision to start practicing this wow, or keep practicing it, because I'm saying I'm going to continue here to go for it. And I made a decision. Okay, I'm going to discipline myself now and make a full-on effort here. Listen, I'm going to do that. So, as I said, it's a 50-50 right now. For me, it's, maybe 50-50 that some, payoff's going to be here. And that would be, some sort of wow situation. That can help the decision to step away from the brink, turn away from the brink. That this conundrum, you realize that it really isn't there. There really isn't a paradox there. Truth is not paradoxical. We're not created by a paradoxical God at all. Not at all. And you can feel it, and feeling that is enough to stop you from the brink and say, well, no, I'm not going to do that. That's enough. And then discipline full stop in the wow. Discipline it. And this will help even more. Very important to manage your success. Very important. Of paramount importance to manage your success this way. So, I'll get this video up here. We will continue here. Don't try to spin any scenario, future scenario of expectations. Don't attach words, concepts, images to this wow feeling. Just remain abstract. It's beyond words. It cannot be measured or defined. The profundity cannot be measured or defined at all. So I'm just going to accept this fact and remain in this sort of abstract state of mind. And don't try to label it. Beyond saying what sort of abstract state of mind, just a wow state of mind, full stop, wow, But don't go any further than that. Don't elaborate upon it. Don't get pulled into a paradox. There is no paradox here. Either there's a rope or a snake. It's not both. And we're saying it's a rope. Okay, it's that simple. There's no paradox. We're saying there's nothing we need to do to get rid of the snake. Absolutely nothing we need to do to get rid of a snake. It was never there. So we rest in pure abstraction of no effort, no doingness, no A and B, no this leading to that. No explanation. Well, how do we get rid of the snake? No explanation. Well, how do we succeed? No success. What do? We didn't do anything. Rest in that. and don't try to assess your progress. It's very important. It cannot be, you know, assessed from a you know, conceptual dualistic standpoint. You cannot really, but you can certainly, by practicing this full stop in the wow, I would say this is very helpful. But I don't want to try to measure the helpfulness of it. Don't try to measure it. Just know that this is very extraordinarily helpful. And maybe immeasurably helpful, we could say. It's measurably helpful. And just leave it at that. Again, abstract. Keep practicing this abstract state of mind beyond words. Okay. Well, I'll keep putting in the effort here. Just keep practicing full stop on the wow as much as possible. This will be, you know, very, very, very helpful, actually. It is helpful, will be helpful. It does open up doors for you that only this practice can open up, actually. Because this helps you manage your success, and it opens up the door to, you know, success. Without trying to define what that success is. So, see if you can reach a tipping point, you know, where you decide, you know what, I'm going to go either this way or that way. I'm going to get out of the middle, so-called middle of trying, you know, the paradoxical middle. I don't want to do that. Should I go this way or go that way? You know, and see if you can't decide. 50-50 is better than nothing, you know, nothing. That's just a no-brainer, really, right? It's not that difficult. Don't know what's next. You never know what's around the corner. I woke up from a nap this afternoon and my mind suddenly went quiet, you know? I didn't have, yeah, so you just don't know. You just don't know what's around the corner. And it's better to say, you know, at least 50-50, you know, it could be something, you know, it could be really a nice, very nice payoff, you know? So that's worth remaining dedicated to. Okay, very great. I'm going to end this one now. Just full stop in the wow. And remain serious, remain sober. And poised. And keep the faith. Very great. That's it. Full stop.